The search engine Google is showing this doodle in many countries for celebrating 131st birthday of Lucy Wills. Lucy Wills was a leading English haematologist. Haematology is the branch of medicine concerned with the study of the cause, treatment, and prevention of diseases related to blood. Lucy Wills was born on this day in 1888. That is on May 10th, around 131 years back. English girls had few opportunities for education and entry into the professions, particularly medicine, until towards the end of the 19th century. Lucy Wills was of a generation which benefited from the work of various radical Victorian reformers. Lucy Wills attended the Cheltenham College for Young Ladies, one of the first British boarding schools to train female students in science and mathematics. In 1911, she earned first honors in botany and geology at Cambridge University's Newnham College, another institution at the forefront of educating women, followed by the London School of Medicine for Women, the first school in Britain to train female doctors. After completing her medical degree, Lucy Wills decided not to practice as a physician, but to research and teach in the Department of Chemical Pathology at the Royal Free, a major teaching hospital in London. Then Lucy Wills traveled to India to investigate a severe form of life-threatening anemia affecting pregnant textile workers in Bombay. Suspecting that poor nutrition was the cause, she discovered what came to be known as the Wills factor when a laboratory monkey's health improved after being fed the British breakfast spread Marmite, which is made of yeast extract. Later research proved the factor to be folate, whose synthetic form is folic acid, which is now recommended to pregnant women all over the world. Lucy Wills was back again at the Royal Free from 1938 until her retirement in 1947. During the Second World War, she was a full-time pathologist in the emergency medical service. Work in the pathology department was disturbed for a few days in July 1944 when the hospital suffered a direct hit from a V-1 flying bomb. By the end of the war, she was in charge of pathology at the Royal Free and had established the first hematology department there. After her retirement, Lucy Wills travelled extensively, including to Jamaica, Fiji and South Africa, continuing her observations on nutrition and anemia. Lucy Wills never married. She was a generation which had lost a large number of its young men on the Western Front. She was close to her parents, her siblings and their children. Lucy Wills, even in her 70s, was always a tireless worker. Wills enjoyed mountain climbing, cross-country skiing, and rode a bicycle to work rather than driving in a car. She devoted much of her life to traveling the world and working to ensure the health of mothers-to-be.